fight immunity. Would be going live, but microphone capability has been disabled on that. Maybe it's malicious. I'll get that straightened out. That's the biggest gangs pretending they got warrants for me again, too. Biggest gang in the area. Erie County Sheriff's Office. Violence.
It's on Delvin Drive, right?
Yeah.
That's why we offer the lowest price guarantee. If you find a better price online or in store, we'll match it.
Now you can. What's the address again?
877.
Like Scott's, LG, and DeWalt. So take on your price.
The Grider is on 877 Grider.
Yeah.
Home improvement retail partner of the NFL.
Oh, there's no one Delvin. So you get back a Grider.
Yeah.
Okay. Gosh.
After last week, no thanks.
Avoiding foods due to fear of.
I thought it'd be right at the corner.
The street doesn't go around here, does it? See a stop sign down there?
Yeah. You build a new construction under your apartment building. Surprised to see that.
Low income housing, go figure.
Well, they tore down all the old houses, you know, not all of them, but a lot of beautiful old houses. This area. Buildings like that not being used. Why would you build something out of a, you know, you got that brick structure right there?
Yeah.
Not being used. They're building stuff out of aspenite down the street. I don't understand. They just tore down that beautiful brick. It's got to be that way now.
Which way?
That way.
Dayquil Kids Berry from Vicks.
We can't see numbers,
holy,
I think.
Oh, yeah. Holy Ghost Temple. Should be cars in the parking lot, too. Should be a building I can spot. Never been there before.
Is our house over here? 211.
211.
231. This is back.
Must be.
The address is on Grider, right?
Yeah. Or no, it's on 877 East Delavan.
Oh.
Yeah. And it wasn't right there, so. Yeah. Suck at that GPS, but when you get a video going, I thought it'd be. I'd stand right up. No numbers on anything.
There's a number there, but I can't read it. 813.
Church, right there.
813.
Alert to all Americans who own a vehicle with less than 200,000 miles with an auto warranty about
835. All right, we're going the right way.
Due to a decline in the economy, First Service is announcing a low cost.
Yeah, you know where we're at.
Vehicle protection that is now available.
Because we're right by the fucking
East Delavan.
Right by the Burberry.
Oh yeah, 874. Almost nothing for covered. That's it. That's it right there.
You heard that correct.
No. Almost nothing. East
Sullivan Community Center for Buffaloians against qualified immunity. Everyone eating in there? Is there a lot of people in there?
Just isn't available because these people do not want to charge problem that the Supreme Court is the judicial branch and shouldn't be making law in the first place, only interpreting it?
You're 110% correct. That's another reason that we're being involved. The Supreme Court can't make law. How did they do this? They shouldn't have done this. You want to add that?
Yeah, just so the modern doctrine of qualified immunity doesn't come from 1982. It actually existed a long time before that, back in the Pinkertons, and it was really meant to cover kind of what you were talking about, the really unclear, could anyone have made this mistake? And then that became too broad, KKK was using it, and all the civil rights activists and being attacked in states not actually enforcing anything, so that's when Congress passed it. The problem is that the court then said, well, if Congress didn't explicitly get rid of qualified immunity in the statute, meaning put in the statute that you can't use it anymore, that it must still exist, which is, this is the only statute I've ever heard to interpret that not saying a defense exists means it exists. And that's the problem we have now, that they're interpreting in that gap. They didn't make the law, they just said Congress needs to explicitly state it's gone. That's how they kind of get around that. And even if they were making the law, there's really nothing to do about it, except Congress amending it, which they're not gonna do because even the ones who are progressive leaning, a lot of them have those fears that you brought up of, the poor police officers who are, shooting people because they're constantly under the threat of gunfire like they're in a war zone, which none of that is accurate, but the myths are what has led Congress to be unable to do anything, and the court took advantage of it in the 70s and never fixed it. So that's why we're stuck.
And Congress did, in fact, say that you can't sue police. That's called Section 1983.
Yeah.
That was created as part of the Ku Klux Klan Act, which was meant to create a cause of action against government officials who were violating people's rights. And that was done during the Reconstruction era after the Civil War.
Wow.
What happened was that was not used extensively until the 1960s. And there's a case called Pearson v. Gray, in which people who were participating in the freedom rights. Arrested in, I think it was Mississippi, for being in a segregated cafe. And they were arrested, and the government said, well, basically, this law that they were arrested under is technically illegal under the Constitution, but because they couldn't have known this at the time, therefore, we can't hold these police officers accountable. So they were allowed for that. And that doctrine, that particular opinion, expanded and expanded over the years to what it is today. 1983, 1982, rather, was the year in which they basically created the modern.
Yeah, there actually, this was 3 or 4 years ago, I think. There was one regarding doctors that are employed by the state in jails, I think it was, or prisons, right? Okay, yeah. And SCOTUS didn't take it, right? If they just left the law report said,
no, but if they're employed by the state,
yeah. It was kind of like they were in a weird gray area that was left off.
Yeah, when they did with contractors sometimes fall into that. There was a case where a private investigator, I believe this was from California, was hired to figure out, and I might get these facts a little bit wrong, but I believe he was hired to investigate whether a fireman was abusing his sick time. And the private investigator basically did a bunch of things that would have been violations. They sued and said that the private investigator would have covered that fault.
And Judge Jackson was right.
Sure. Yes,
what about suing them in their individual capacity, because when they step outside the scope of their duties, they're no longer cloaked with the immunity of, you know, of their uniform.
They still get qualified immunity.
Qualified immunity applies to